Howdy y'all, it's Chris with Show Up Fitness, favorite trainer with a belt buckle. Today we're going to be going over body fat percentage. Before we get into that, make sure to follow us on YouTube and also Instagram. If you want to become a trainer, Show Up Fitness, personal training internship. So body fat percentage, way better of an indicator of health versus the BMI. BMI gets knocked around a lot, body mass index, it's terrible, blah, blah, blah. It's not bad, it works. It does not take in consideration muscle mass. I can look at someone and they could be overweight to obese on the BMI and they have more muscle and you can just recognize that. I'm technically borderline overweight to obese. I love that statistic. I can call myself overweight to obese because of the BMI. I'm not going to lose sleep over it because my insides are good, my blood is good, I have low blood pressure. Those are the more important things. Body fat percentage, we're going to go over all the numbers, the essential, and different testing tools that you can use. Let's go over the range first. We got guys and girls. Essential means this is the bare minimum that you need for reproductive organs. For girls, it's going to be reproduction. Amenorrhea can kick in when you go below 12% potentially. So essential for guys, 2 to 5%. Girls, 8 to 12%. Athletes, let's say 6 to 13 for guys. Girls, 14 to 20. So when you start getting into your teens as a girl, you may potentially lose your period, but it's not because of the workouts. You gotta look at the bigger stuff, sleep, stress, how's that going? I once had a girl in class, she was 22% body fat. She blamed it on lifting too heavy of weights. She was sleeping on average 3 hours a night. That is why you are probably losing your period. Go talk with your doctor, always. I'm not a physician, I'm not a registered dietitian. But if you're not sleeping well, your body's going to be in a state of fight or flight and a lot of stress, and that's probably why you're not having your period. If you are missing your period, that's not a good thing. Get that checked out by a doctor. That term is called amenorrhea. You're above average, 14 to 17%, 21 to 24. A good rule of thumb, once you can start seeing, it's called your inguinal ligament, the sexy V abs for guys. It's not an ab, it's just a ligament, inguinal ligament. Once you can start seeing that, you're probably hovering around 10 to 12%, maybe a little below that. Average 18 to 24% for guys, 25 to 30 for girls. And when you go above 25 for men, you are considered obese. For girls, it's 30%. And that's the problem with our whole epidemic today. People are dying of coronary artery disease. They're getting diseases like metabolic diseases, such as kidney problems and other terrible conditions due to the excess adiposity. Make sure to check out our other video on the body mass equation, and that's going to go over why we are gaining weight. And there's a lot of factors. It's not just about calories. It is, but there's other things that are important as well as the energy output. So as a nation, we're eating more, about 450 calories. We're not moving as much, roughly 250. So together, that's 700 calories. Obviously, we're going to gain weight. We want to blame it on its hormones, its my genes, it's a metabolic condition, but we've never had it checked out. It's just the easy way out. At the end of the day, you gotta monitor what you're putting into your mouth and you gotta work out pretty damn hard if you want the results. So we're gonna go over the BIA, which is bioelectrical impedance analysis. Anytime someone gives you an acronym, you better be able to tell me what it is. This is the BIA, what's it stand for? I don't know. Imagine going to a doctor and you're like, hey doc, what's that tool? Oh, it's the TFP. Oh, cool, what is that? I don't know. I'm gonna use it on you though. I cut your arm off. I don't think so. So anytime a trainer, you use an acronym, whether it's ATP, BMR, BMI, BIA, know what it stands for. Bioelectrical impedance analysis. The body is primarily composed of water. So this sends a little electrode through your body and it's going to give you a fairly accurate description or prediction of your body fat percentage. Guess who doesn't like this? It's always the same person, the person that doesn't like the number on there. The gold standard is the hydrostatic where you get into a dunk tank. And we've had that come to our school before, and I've had students go in there, they go underwater, you breathe out. Archimedes' principle is the buoyancy of fat, something like that. So you push out all the air in your lungs, and they give you a very, very, very accurate percentage of body fat that you have. Half of the students after did this, the BIA, and it was the same exact. This has a percent of roughly 3 to 5. Some people say as high as 8%. It depends on dehydration, the time of day you're doing it, if your hands are sweaty. Consistency is key. So I tell people, do this 5 days in a row at the same time and see, take the average of it. Like in 3 to roughly 8%, the same with the calipers. I personally hate the calipers for a bunch of reasons. Hi, my name is Chris, I'm your trainer. When you start pinching your fat, how does that start off from a psychological standpoint if you're gonna have a client who's gonna start working with you? This is so much easier, it's better than the scale, but unfortunately we need the scale to get that number. Hold your hands out, push start, you hold for maybe 10 seconds, it gives you a number, then you can educate your client. This is a starting point, this is a really cool number. Mrs. Jones, you were 38%. I'm not gonna say you're obese. I'm gonna say 38%, this is a really cool number. You're just gonna watch it go down over the months of training with me. I'm gonna suggest you train 3 times a week, and after 6 months, you're gonna look back and this number is gonna be 25, 24, 22, whatever it's gonna be, and you're gonna be a lot healthier, you're gonna feel better, you're gonna move better, your mindset's gonna be completely different. So don't use this as a fear tactic to scare people, but the higher you go, the greater the likelihood you're gonna have diabetes or coronary artery disease, nasty stuff. You do have to be careful if people have a pacemaker. You can usually tell someone has it looks like a bump in their chest. So just ask anytime you administer this, do you have a pacemaker or any heart problems? If they do, I would not want to use this. When it comes to calipers, the ACSM, American College of Sports Medicine, they set the rules for it. As a technician, you should do 100 people before you start practicing on regular folk. Trainers use this as a scare tactic. I've seen people walk around at 24. I've seen it at Gold's, Equinox, and they just, hey, let me take your body fat percentage. Start pinching people, they do it one time. They do it in weird spots. I've seen people do it on the glutes, inner thigh, like, no, that's not how this is used. There's 9 total sites that the ACSM has. We have the tricep, the bicep, the pec, the mid-axilla, superiliac, your thigh, your calf, your subscap, and your abdominals. Those are the 9, of which 2 they suggest not doing on anyone except for kids. Why the hell are you gonna use this on a kid, first of all? But your calf and your bicep is what they do on kids. Again, I prefer doing a BIA or just not even doing it, who cares? You can do a measurement if you wanted to, but just be real careful and have people supervising you, especially parents, if you were to do it for whatever freaking reason. I suggest not to. But on our clients, I suggest going BIA. But if you were to use the caliper, do the 7-site formula. Go through and you check the spots. You measure, you document it. You go again. If it's outside of 1 to 2 of the millimeters on here, so I do a tricep, it's not how you do it, but if you do tricep and you got 12, next time you come around and it's 16, you gotta do it again because it's outside of a two millimeter reading. It needs to be within 1 to 2 to be accurate. People, trainers specifically, they screw this up so much, and that's why I hate it. One, it messes with the client's mindset because you're pinching on their vulnerable areas. 2, trainers don't do it properly. If you were to want to do this as a trainer, go through the ACSM. I hate why NASM uses the Wormsley, Durin-Wormsley, whatever the hell it's called, their 4-site equation. Bi, tri, superiliac, and subscapularis. How the heck does that work? I don't know many people that store a lot of fat here. Wouldn't you want to do like a thigh on a female because they store more fat there, and for a guy, their abs? NASM, whatever. Body fat. Those are 2 tools that you can use. Whichever one you use, just be consistent and make sure not to base the whole entire assessment off of it. Excess adiposity, it's not good. You don't want to have a bunch of this on your body. This reeks. This is what gets the body inflamed. It's not a chemical, or it's this food, or you're not eating organic, you're gonna die and go to hell. Excess calories are going to create excess fat. Adiposity is why we are a nation that is obese. To be less obese, we gotta focus on the mind and educate people. To get rid of the fat, slight deficit, exercise more, and you're gonna change the body, but it takes time. That's 5 pounds. Give yourself a good 2-3 months to lose 5 pounds. Consistency long-term is what's gonna help you get results. Hydrostatic is gonna be the best. You have a bod pod and the DEX is getting pretty popular now. The BIA and the calipers are roughly 3 to 8%. If you want to do those, I like them the most because they're less harmless. Calipers, it's your choice. At the end of the day, it does not define you. It's just a numeric. I'd much rather go off of how much you can bench, squat, hip thrust, how many pull-ups you can do, and push-up. It's one of the many things to diversify the assessment to help our clients get in the best shape of their life. Hopefully you guys liked today's video on body fat. Make sure to follow us on Show Up Fitness. If you want to become a trainer, Show Up Fitness internship. Next class is going to be June 3rd in Los Angeles. We're hoping to open up a spot in La Jolla, another school, and lots more gyms as we continue to grow. DM us with any questions. Thank you.